Hi everyone. Wow, what an incredible 24 hours it's been. I'm sure, like most of you, been up half the night worrying about Kevin Escoffier on PRB. It was just huge relief in the morning to find out that he'd been picked up by Jean Le Cam, and what an incredible rescue that was. Let's first of all hear from Jean Le Cam. He gave this interview this morning, which is just describing what he did, which is just remarquable.
Moi, je devais être à 2 heures de PRB, non? Un truc comme ça. J'ai plus tous les détails en tête, mais à peu près. Et puis, du coup, j'étais le plus près, si tu veux, de l'objectif. Donc, du coup, je me rends à la position où, si tu veux, la balise disait que le bateau était en détresse. Donc voilà, puis j'arrive sur zone, et puis nickel, je vois Kevin dans son radeau, je lui dis, comme j'ai la position nickel, si tu veux, moi je me dis, bon, voilà, impeccable, quoi. Donc je lui dis, je reviens, quoi, on va pas non plus faire n'importe quoi, si tu veux. Donc là, j'avais deux ris dans la grand-voile, grand-voile seule, mais deux ris dans la grand-voile avec 32 nœuds, si tu veux. C'est pas. Et la mer qu'il y avait, c'était pas fastoche pour manœuvrer. Je reviens, si tu veux, là où j'avais quitté, et personne. Oh là là. Bon, je me dis, bon, allez, je suis revenu au moins 5-6 fois. Alors le tout 5-6 fois, ça fait virement de bord à chaque fois, avec les aléas de droite et de gauche, tu vois, avec la mer, marche arrière à chaque fois, enfin bon. Alors je me dis, bon ben maintenant, tu restes en stand-by là, et puis on attendra le jour. Après je reviens de bord, puis je me dis, peut-être la nuit aussi, la lumière, ça se voit mieux la nuit que le jour, hein, c'est sûr, hein. À un moment, j'étais debout sur le pont, je vois un flash, quoi. Alors un flash, c'est pas un flash, en fait, c'est la lumière qui apparaît dans une vague, tu vois. Une apparition. Je dis, c'est pas vrai, quoi. Et ben, je continue, et puis je continuais, et puis il y avait d'apparitions, forcément. Et puis là, tu vois de plus en plus la lumière. Là, tu dis, putain, c'est bon, quoi. C'est bon. Alors là, t'as que. Là, tu passes du désespoir, si tu veux, tu vois, au truc de dingue, quoi. Et là, je me mets au vent. Et là, je dis à Kevin, je vois Kevin, et puis je lui dis, ben, écoute, il me dit, tu reviens ou quoi? Je dis, non, je reviens pas. On fait tout de suite. Et je lui balance la bouée rouge, l'espèce de banane, là. Et puis, il arrive à la voir, quoi. Et au final, on a réussi. Il a accroché la barre de transmission et là, c'était gagné.
Wow, remarkable, absolutely remarkable. And of course, we've been hearing from Kevin Escoffier later today just about what happened to the boat, which looked like the bow broke away, and he just had minutes to ready himself, get a text message to his shore team, activate his EPIRB, get into his survival suit, and get his life raft ready to abandon the boat. All as the boat is it's filling with water very quickly. Incredible seamanship, both from Kevin and from Jean Le Cam, and of course from all the other boats that went to aid his rescue. Let's have a quick look at the tracker and just see how this played out over the last 24 hours. So this is the situation 24 hours ago, and you can see. Luckily for PRB, there was quite a few boats in and around him which could, in effect, come to his rescue. So here we've got Kevin Escoffier's PRB, and right behind him is Jean Le Cam. And if we just play the tracker forward, you'll see as we move forward, this is the moment where Jean Le Cam catches up with PRB, and this is at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And then at this point, it looks like he's lost them in the evening as the sun's gone down, and three of the other boats have been diverted to his attention, And the first to arrive on seat is Yannick Bestaven, followed by Boris Herrmann, and then Sebastian Simon turns. And what they've been asked to do by the race direction is to form a sort of triangle and start a sort of pyramid style search to see if they can find the life raft, which has got Kevin Escoffier in it. Unbeknown to everyone at the time, and of course, everyone who was watching this play out overnight, Jean Le Cam actually found Kevin in the sort of early hours of the morning. It was a very good moonlit, and had actually managed to get him on board when everyone realised that he was safe and well. Okay, so let's have a look at the routing for the next 24 hours or so. And this was the moment the red boat is routing from Charlie Dallon. And you can see that they've got this fairly deep depression pushing them along over the top of the ice gate. And then they dive south around the Kerguelen Islands as they're looking for better pressure. And the ice gate recedes away and gives them the sort of the southerly latitude to stay in the best pressure. But what I'm interested in is this high pressure system here that is around the bottom of the South Africa, and this potentially is going to give the slow boats behind a real headache to get around, because they can't get south of that high pressure system because of the ice gate, and so they may be becalmed in the Southern Ocean for quite some time, and that means that there's going to be this huge great split between the fleet as we go forward. So that's it from me when the Vendée Globe witnessed one of the most remarkable rescues in its history, and Jean Le Cam saved the day. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow.